中国共产党，取消对中国国家主席任期的宪法限制，等于允许习近平无限期的领导中国。眼看锤将敲下，但是疑问和杂音还在。3月4号，中国13届全国人大开幕前一天，开放提问时，现场记者第一个问题就是：中国为何在此时修宪？
我国现行宪法是符合国情、符合实际、符合时代发展要求的好宪法。宪法只有不断适应新形势、吸纳新经验、确认新成果、做出新规范，才具有持久生命力。
张业穗居于大陆外交体系达42年，2010年担任奥巴马时代的中国驻美大使。但是美国媒体不松手地继续追问，修宪是否将更改国家主席的任期，让习近平终身执政？张业穗回应，当前中共党章或是中共宪法对中央总书记和中央军委主席都没有做出连续任职不得超过2届的规定，因此中共宪法对于国家主席理应也如此办理。
宪法对国家主席的相关规定也采取上述做法，有利于维护以习近平同志为核心的党中央权威和统一领导。
对于中国为何在此时修宪，美国知名杂志 New Yorker 专栏作家 Osmus 认为，习近平可能有2个原因：一是其策略因素，在接班人出现前先下手为强，否则不现在做，再等5年才想做时，习近平可能已经成为跛脚鸭；二是习近平的战略因素。
This is one that's more worrisome, perhaps, is that it also indicates that he's prepared to do really major changes to the country's political and legal landscape in order to protect his position and in order to protect the party against the possibility that would have political turmoil in the future. So he's made the decision now.
不论取消国家主席任期制是习近平为了个人权利还是为了确保国家的改革，结果都将带领中国走上截然不同的道路。即将在5月出版新著《第三次革命：习近平和中国崛起》的美国知名中国问题专家易明认为，中共在1949年建国后，先经历毛泽东时代的30年统治，再经历邓小平时代的30年改革开放，而从2013年开始，中国将再进入习近平领军的第三个30年，而这个时代，中国将不止插旗亚洲而已。
I think Xi Jinping has made very clear that his ambitions do not stop with Asia, the Asia-Pacific region. And in fact, the Belt and Road initiative extends to 69 countries, not only in Asia, but in Europe, in Africa, and in the Middle East. And I think he's looking to remake global order, the rules of the road, in ways that suit China more. I mean, he has said, you know, in one of his speeches back in 2014,that he wants China not only to help write the rules of the game, but also to construct the playground on which the games are played. He has a very ambitious vision for China's role and its centrality in the global system 5-10 years out.
习近平在此时提出取消任期制，或许他认为稳定才能确保实现他所设定的中华民族复兴和成为世界强国的目标。但纽约时报专栏作家 CNN 主持人 Zakaria 对此质疑。 Zakaria 认为习近平的长期执政将让中国走在危险的道路上，因为后果将破坏中国过去所建立的三大特色：一是对独裁的限制，二是经济奇迹，三是越来越体制化的政治制度。
In 1982, the Chinese Communist Party wrote into the country's constitution that its president and vice presidentcould serve no more than 2 consecutive terms. This made China unique, a dictatorship with term limits. In most authoritarian regimes, the ruler accumulates power and over the years becomes more arrogant, corrupt, and unaccountable. This wasn't possible in the Chinese system, which limited any individual's power and focused instead on the collective, the party. China's unique model also produced an economic miracle. wise long-range planning, and smart pro-growth economic policies. Since 1978, China's GDP has grown at an astounding average annual rate of almost 10%, which the World Bank calls the fastest sustained expansion by a major economy in history. In addition, for decades, China seemed to be getting more institutionalized politically. China is eliminating perhaps the central restraint in a political system that provides staggering amounts of power to the country's leaders. What will that do over time to the ambitions and appetites of leaders? Power tends to corrupt, Lord Acton famously wrote in 1887, and absolute power corrupts absolutely. Perhaps China will avoid this tendency, but it has been widespread throughout history.
强人政治崛起的当前国际政治，几乎所有国际局势专家都认同。如今几乎没有哪个国家拥有道德立场、权威甚至是性质，可以对强人政治表示异议，包括美国自己。万味的是，《纽约时报》不久前才以一幅漫画讽刺美国。当白宫官员提问我们应该如何应对中国这次政治变化，川普说：“替我送上祝贺。”果然，3月3号，川普在佛州与共和党金主的闭门随性谈话时，川普谈起习近平的取消任期。他说：“太棒了。
”John is great, and she is a great gentleman. He's now president for life. President for life. No, he's great. He's, hey, look, he was able to do that. I think it's great. Maybe we'll have to give that a shot someday.